As a new streamer, the biggest problem you face is being found and being remembered. There are already thousands of streamers and new streamers starting daily, making it harder for viewers to be able to decide who to watch. So the question is, how do you stand out? Well, the easiest way to be able to stand out is to have overlays on your stream. They take your stream from looking like this, which is boring, to this, which looks professional. So if you want a professional looking stream that will help you get noticed and be remembered, you're gonna wanna watch this video to the end. I'm gonna go ahead and take you step by step on setting up your overlays inside of Streamlabs, and I'm even going to go ahead and give you a stream overlay package that you're gonna be able to download for free directly on streamdesigns.com. So simply go to the description of the video, click on the link, and at checkout, enter the coupon code FREESTREAMOVERLAY, and you'll be all set. So let's go ahead and dive into Streamlabs. So the first overlay that we're gonna go ahead and set up, it's gonna be your starting soon. This is gonna be the scene that you're gonna utilize as soon as you go live. It's gonna be what's gonna build up the hype before you come up on screen. So to be able to set this up, we're gonna go ahead and hit this plus icon, and we're gonna go ahead and select image. We're gonna then go ahead and select add source, and then we're gonna name this starting. Okay, you're gonna select add source, and then what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna browse the files that you went ahead and downloaded from Stream Designz. So we'll select starting soon, you'll select okay, you'll hit done, and then what you'll do is that you'll right click on the image, you'll select transform, and you'll select fit to screen. So the next feature that we wanna go ahead and add is gonna be a countdown timer. This is gonna let your viewers know how long before you go live. So what we wanna do is you wanna go to the description of this video, you're gonna wanna go to lastcurry.com/countdown-timer-tool, which is a free countdown timer tool that I went ahead and created for you to be able to utilize. So once you're here on the starting minutes, you're gonna select 5 minutes. You're then gonna select font color. You can put any color you want. I go ahead and put black, and then go ahead and hit get timer. What this is gonna do is it's gonna give you a URL that we're gonna wanna copy to be able to paste inside of Streamlabs. So you'll copy that link, and then we'll go to Streamlabs, and what you want to do is under sources, you want to hit the plus icon, you want to come to where it says browser source, and then you want to select add source. We'll go ahead and label this countdown. You'll select add source, and then what you want to do is here where it says URL, you want to go ahead and paste the URL you got for the countdown timer. Then you'll simply go ahead and hit close, and you'll see that the timer is now visible. So we'll move it slightly exactly where we want it to be, and we'll have it live there. So the next thing we want to go ahead and add is going to be alerts. This is going to be the notifications and the names that pop up on screen when somebody follows, when somebody subscribes, when somebody donates. That way you can show appreciation to your viewers for the action that they took. So to be able to do this, what you want to do is you want to go to the description of the video, you're going to want to go to streamelements.com, and you're going to want to go ahead and get logged in with your Twitch account. Once you got logged in, you're going to come to the left hand side where it says my overlays, you're going to select create new overlay, and what we're going to want to do is you're going to want to go ahead and utilize the alerts that you got included in your package from Stream Designz. So here you'll select start, you'll come down to this plus icon, you'll select alert box, and then what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna go ahead and set up one of the alerts, and then you can go ahead and use the steps to set up the others. So we're gonna go ahead and set up the follow alert. So you wanna select this little gear icon, you're gonna select set image, and then you're gonna wanna go ahead and upload the image from the package you received. So you'll select upload, select files, and then we'll go ahead and select the new follower alert. You'll have it uploaded, select upload, and then you're gonna wanna hit submit. So now you're gonna see that the image is set up, but that's not the only step we need to take. So where it says layout, you're gonna wanna select text over image. You're gonna wanna scroll down to where it says text settings. You wanna make sure that it's centered. And then what we wanna do is you wanna come to where it says advanced, and here you're gonna wanna select 100. over 150. And what this is gonna do is gonna go ahead and center it. So if you come here and hit emulate, you'll hit follow, and you'll see here that now the name and everything is appearing just as we want it. So what you wanna do is you wanna go ahead and hit save. You're gonna name this alerts. Okay, and you're gonna hit save. And then what we wanna do is you wanna come to this little paperclip icon, and you wanna copy and click there so it copies the URL. We're gonna come back to Streamlabs, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna hit the plus icon, you're gonna hit browser source again, you're gonna hit add source, you're gonna go ahead and add a new source instead. We're gonna name this alerts, and you're gonna go ahead and hit add source. So what we're gonna do is same thing, you're gonna paste the URL, You're gonna go ahead and then hit close. And what you wanna do is you wanna come back to Stream Elements because we wanna go ahead and run a few tests. So under emulate, what you wanna do is you wanna just click the follow button just a few times to make it pop up a few times on screen. And then you'll see here that now we can go ahead and move this around and make it the size that we want. That way, when people show up and they follow, they can show up on screen, building up the hype and getting other people to do the same while you wait to go live. So now that you have your Starting Soon set up, the next thing we want to set up is a Just Chatting. This is going to be the scene where you're going to be able to just spend time engaging with your viewers and building that connection that's going to help you grow. So to be able to do this, we're going to hit plus. You're going to add a new scene and we're going to name this Intermission. Okay, you're going to hit done. And then what we're going to want to do is on the sources, you're going to hit the plus icon. You're going to come to where it says image. You're going to hit add source. And what we're going to do is you're going to add a new source. All right, so once you have the new source, we're going to go ahead and name this chatting. You're going to go ahead and select add source. And then we're going to go ahead and browse for the intermission screen. You go ahead and hit open. You'll hit done. And then what we want to do is we want to right click on the image, select transform, and then select fit to screen. So next, we're going to go ahead and add our camera. So to be able to do that, you want to hit the plus sign. You're going to select the video capture device. You're going to hit add source. You're going to name this camera. You're gonna select add source, and then we're gonna have our camera. I have my cam link. You'll hit close, and then what we wanna do is we wanna move the chatting screen above the camera, select the camera, and then we can go ahead and size it and position it in the box where it needs to be. Okay, so next we're gonna go ahead and add our gameplay that's gonna fill in the box on the top right. So to be able to do that, we're gonna select the plus sign again, video capture device, add source. We're gonna sit add new. We're gonna label this game, and then you're gonna go ahead and hit add source. We're then gonna go ahead and select our gameplay, which there's my capture card. We'll hit close, and once again, you'll move the chatting screen above the game. Okay, we'll move that. And now what we want to do is we want to size the gameplay until we have it in the top right hand box. So we'll just keep sizing it. Okay, once we have it where we want it, next we're going to want to go ahead and add our alerts. And since we already created them the first time, we don't need to create them again. So to be able to add them to the scene, you're going to set the plus sign. You're going to go to browser source. You're going to hit add source. And then we're gonna select the alerts that we have selected. Once you have that there, what I want you to do is come back to Stream Elements, and then I want you to go ahead and hit emulate, hit follow a few times, and then I want you to come right back so you can be able to position this where you want it to live. And lastly, for this scene, we're gonna wanna add our chat. So this is gonna allow viewers to be able to see themselves chatting on your stream. So to be able to do that, we're gonna come back to Stream Elements. We're gonna go ahead and create a new overlay, okay? And then once the editor is open, we're gonna select 1080p, and we're gonna go ahead and start a new overlay, and we're gonna go ahead and add our chat. So to be able to do that, at the bottom left-hand side, once you select start, you're gonna click this little plus icon, and you're gonna go to Streamer Tools, your stream chat, okay? You're gonna go ahead and select custom under the theme. We're gonna go ahead and change the color to a red just to be able to see it, select. And then we'll come down here to positioning and size, and the width, we'll go ahead and put this at 500. Then we'll go ahead and hit save. Okay, we'll name this chat. You'll select save. And then what you wanna do is you wanna copy the URL, come back to Streamlabs. We're gonna hit this little plus icon. You're gonna select browser source. You're gonna hit add source. We're gonna hit add new source instead. And we're gonna go ahead and label this chat. You're gonna go ahead and hit add source. And then we're gonna go ahead and paste the URL that we just went ahead and copied. You'll go ahead and hit close, okay? It'll take a few seconds for the chat to be able to pop up, but once it pops up, it's gonna be red. This is why I selected that. And then what we wanna do is we wanna make sure that the chatting window is above the chat. Once again, we'll select the chat, and then here's where we'll be able to go ahead and size it where we need it to be. So we'll just come here. We'll size it and we'll position the chat where it needs to be. Now what I want to do is you want to come back to Stream Elements. You want to click on the layers. You then want to come to where it says your stream chat. You want to go to settings. You want to go to theme, and then you want to select the dark chat, hit save. And then when we come back to Streamlabs, you'll see here now it's going to be transparent and ready to go. So the next screen that we're going to go ahead and set up, it's going to be your gameplay. This is going to be the scene where you're going to spend probably 90% of the time where you're going to be playing your games. So what we want to do is you want to come here to the right, right click. We want to duplicate, and we want to name this gameplay. Okay, you're gonna go ahead and hit done. And what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna go ahead and remove the chatting window. So we'll hit remove. We'll go ahead and remove the chat. You can keep the chat if you want. I personally don't keep the chat on the main gameplay. We're gonna keep our alerts, we're gonna keep our camera, and we're gonna keep our game. Now, before we go ahead and dive in, let me know if you play on your PlayStation or an Xbox to stream, because I'm always looking for new people to be able to play with. So make sure you comment that below. So what we wanna do here is we're gonna wanna go ahead and hide the camera for the time being. We're gonna select the game, and we're gonna go ahead and select transform, and we're gonna select fit to screen so we can have the gameplay as big as possible. Then we're gonna go ahead and lock it. We're then gonna go ahead and select our alerts, and what you wanna do is, once again, you're gonna wanna come to stream elements. You're gonna wanna go where it says your alerts, hit it a few times, then you're gonna wanna go ahead and come back to Streamlabs to be able to see where your alert's at, and you can go ahead and position them where you see fit. So next we're gonna go ahead and grab our camera, we're gonna bring it above the game, and now what we're gonna do is you're gonna just size it slightly and leave it pretty big for the time being, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and add our webcam overlay. So to be able to do that, you're gonna hit the plus icon, you're gonna come to where it says image, you're gonna select add source, we're gonna name add a new source, we're gonna name this web, and then you're gonna go ahead and hit add source. We're gonna go ahead and hit browse, and we're gonna go ahead and select the face cam. You'll select open, you'll select done, we'll right click on it, hit transform, we'll select fit to screen, and then what we wanna do is we wanna size it until it covers our webcam. Once we have it aligned where we want it to, I want you to hit control, select the camera, and then right click, and then I want you to go ahead and hit group into folder. You'll just leave it as full new folder, you'll select okay, and now what we can do is that we can move this together without losing it. Now we can go ahead and resize this, position this where we want it to be. It could be on the bottom left, bottom right, it's to your liking. Then you can go ahead and lock it, okay? And now you can see here that we have our gameplay, our webcam, and we have our alerts on our gameplay scene. So now all your scenes are pretty much finished and you're ready to go live. But before you hit that go live button, it's so important that you make sure you have the proper settings inside of Streamlabs set up, so that way your viewers have a good experience, your stream doesn't lag. So what I want you to do is I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here where I go through the best settings for Streamlabs so you have a good looking stream. I'll see you in the next one.